हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल सी मल्टी स्टेजिंग ऑफ सेंट्रीफ्यूगल पंप। ओके, मल्टी स्टेजिंग ऑफ सेंट्रीफ्यूगल पंप। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट इज मल्टी स्टेजिंग एंड व्हाई इट इज रिक्वायर्ड। ओके, सो मल्टी स्टेजिंग मीन्स देर आर नंबर ऑफ पंप्स आर कनेक्टेड टू ईच अदर। ओके, आइदर दे विल बी इन सीरीज और दे विल बी इन पैरेलल। नाउ वी विल सी व्हाई द मल्टी स्टेजिंग इज रिक्वायर्ड। See, multi-staging is required because suppose the pump need to deliver, let's say high head or high pressure, high discharge. Okay, and if we want to deliver that high head or high discharge with a single pump, then the size of pump will go on increasing. Okay, and it will be very large. Okay, and it is very impossible to handle that large single pump. Hence, to avoid that thing, the pumps are connected in stages. Okay, so there are basically two methods of multi-staging. One is pumps are connected in series, and other pumps are connected in parallel. Now, when to use which method? So, whenever we want to have the high head. In that case, the pumps are connected in series, and whenever we want to have the high discharge, okay, whenever we want to have the high discharge, in that case, the pumps will be connected in parallel. Okay, now first we'll see what I mean by pumps in series. Okay, so the pumps in series, as I said, whenever head requirement is high, in that case, the pumps will be connected in series. Now there will be two or more identical impellers are mounted on the same shaft and enclosed in a same casing. All the impellers are connected in series so that liquid discharge with increased pressure from one impeller and it will be passes through the next impeller through the connecting passages. Okay. Now whenever this particular liquid is passing from one impeller to other impeller through the connecting passages, the pressure will go on increasing. Now these impellers are surrounded by guide vanes. Okay, these impellers will be surrounded by guide vanes. Are they mostly they will be in the connecting passages? They will be provided in connecting passages. Now why the use of what is the use of this guide vanes? Basically, these are used to recover the velocity energy of liquid leaving the impeller into the pressure energy. So whatever velocity drop will be there, that will be converted into the pressure energy in the connecting passages, and for that the guide vanes will be used, as well as it will give the path for the liquid. Okay, so whenever the number of two or more identical impellers are mounted on the same shaft and enclosed in the same casing, okay, in that case it is called as the impellers are connected in series. Like that, there will be number of impellers are connected, and that is known as the multi-staging pumps in series. Okay, now we will observe this particular diagram of head and the velocity. Here you can see I have written H1, H2, H1, H2, V1, V0. Okay, and I have given at the bottom, that is IG. I stands for impeller, G stands for guide vanes. Okay, so there are three stages I have shown. So first, liquid passes through the impeller, the velocity will increase. Okay, and when the liquid is passing through the guide vanes, that is through the connecting passage, so here you can see this is the one impeller, this is another impeller, this is a third impeller, like that. So liquid will be passing through the impeller, velocity will increase. In the guide vanes, the velocity will decrease. However, this decrease of guide velocity will increase the pressure. Okay, so here initially the pressure head is like this one. Now in the impeller the head will increase, again in guide vane the head will increase, again in the next impeller the head will increase, guide vane head will increase, and so on. The head will go on increasing and we will be getting the increased head over there. However, the discharge will remain same because the same liquid is passing through the number of impellers. So there is no additional the liquid is provided. So the same liquid is passing, so the discharge remains same. However, the head will go on increasing. Okay, now H1 is what? The head gain in impeller. So this is for impeller. head gain in impeller, and H2 is the head gain in guide vanes. It is what the head gain in guide vanes. Okay. So the total head HM will be H1 plus H2. The total head HM will be H1 plus H2. So the dotted line, this particular dotted line shows the total head line. These are nothing but the velocity line. Okay. So this is what actually the perms are in series. Suppose there are n number of stages, then HM will be, if there are n number of stages, then HM will be H1 plus H2. H1 plus H2. Okay. So this is what the perms are in series. Okay. Now this particular how many stages is to be used, that will be depends upon the what is the limitation of speed, then discharge and the total head requirement. Okay. So based on the limitation of motor speed, that is driving motor speed, what is the discharge required and what is the head required, based on that the number of stages will be decided. Okay. Now generally it is said that the specific speed should not exceed 700 rpm, and the maximum head per stage should not be more than 160 meter. Okay. So speed should not be more than 700 rpm, and head per stage not more than 160 meter. Okay. So this is what the perms are in series. Now we'll see what do you mean by perms are in parallel. Okay. Now as we discussed in pumps in series, that is for the high head. In case of pumps in series, the discharge remains same. Okay. So the discharge is same. However, in case of pumps in parallel, discharge is increased, however head remains same. Head will be remaining same. Okay. So when large quantity of liquid is required to be pumped against relatively small heads, then with a single pump it is not possible. In that case, the pumps will be, two or more pumps will be connected in parallel. These pumps are individual pumps. Okay. These pumps are individual pump, and they will be taking the liquid from the common sump and delivering that particular same liquid to the common delivery or the storage. Okay. However, pump will be individual. Okay. So the total delivery, or the suppose individual pump is delivering, let's say Q1, Q2, Q3 and so on till Qn. This is what the discharge through the individual pump. Then the total discharge Qt, I'll be writing like Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 plus so on plus Qn. Okay. So this is what the total discharge, that is the total discharge when there are now individual pumps are connected in parallel. So in case of pumps are in parallel, discharge will be more and head will remain same. Okay. So individual pump will suck the water from or the liquid from a common sump, and it will be delivered to the common storage. So this is what the pumps in series, high head with the same discharge. Pumps in parallel, high discharge with the same head. Okay. So this is what nothing but the multi-staging of a centrifugal pump. Thank you.